Okay.
Even when I went from my old car to this one.
Because our first guy.
And I had, yeah, still had my old car for like a month.
Hello. I'm Jamie Krieger. I'm here with Amiga on the Lake. And basically, we're over here talking about the advanced visual development.
And getting out of the new car and getting
the soon to be released, the new full time development on it. Sponsored by Amiga on the Lake. It'll be for sale exclusively from Amiga on the Lake. So AmigaOnTheLake.com.
200 horsepower.
And we're going to do our early adopters release before December 5th of this year, where you can purchase it for $100 less.
Cool.
And then as soon as 1.0, and then so you can play with it while we go the rest of it, and then when 1.0 comes out, it'll be, you know, full price, so get in early.
That's right.
Good, thank you.
Hi folks, I'm Jeff Yoder, one half of Amiga on the Lake, and as you can see, you brought the store with us, but any other time you come to AmigaOnTheLake.com, preferably when we get back to New York, and we have all this back there ready to sell. We have a wide variety of classic now. We keep adding new products all the time for the classic Amiga. But our biggest focus is on the new gen with the X5000 and the hopefully soon to be released table for A1222. Looking forward to that. That's hopefully what we think will be the best machine to expand the Amiga market. So, but yeah, please visit AmigaOnTheLake.com and see what we have to offer. It's a classic, and more and more stuff for new gen as well. So thank you for your time.
Well, you're on tape.
So it's on here somewhere.
Do 4,000 boards?
You can find the archive. I got a lot of junk on there. Please don't copy everything. Just the file.
Your name is?
Oh, I guess it is me. Hey, I'm Paul Resendez. This is the new 4,000 board. Morph OS. Amiwest 2018. Excellent time. You guys should all come out.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Alex.
What do you have here?
Okay, so that's my X1000 in a custom case. It's kind of a maker case. It's got an Arduino inside the ESC32. It's got top secret controlled by the ESC32. And both of them are very accessible from the Amiga site using a serial terminal. And I have multiple serial ports.
All right, so you're going to go.
It's got a bunch of displays in the front that can control also from scripts or using shell commands. It's got a RAM drive, so instead of a hard drive, it's actually memory sticks. So it's super fast to read, write, to see. I think that's it.
You good? You need a picture of it?
Alright.
And your name is?
I'm checking in. He's old. It'll be a while.
Okay.
Sorry.
Sorry. Okay, now he's
displaying my latest project here. It's an I.O. interface adapter for classic Amigas. It uses the Raspberry Pi to let you use regular USB keyboards, mice, and gamepads with your classic Amigas. And the other nice thing it does is it also also allows you to mount a thumb drive as an Amiga disk drive.
You see the thumb drive is flashing and it shows up on the desktop.
And now I can
look at one of the PDF files I have on it.
Get on there.
Pulls the PDF right off the thumb drive.
Oh, yeah.
And so that's what I'm showing this week.
Thanks, Chris.
Hello there.
That's a great show. When you ask for feedback about doing more things, I'm always
I find it very good. I'm sorry.
What's that? So, yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Don't be nervous. They're checking us out, Matthew. We're two Amiga dealers. We're conspiring to grow Amiga OS 4, and it's working, folks.
Hi, Robert.
Thank you.